Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my second video on cloud storage in Google Cloud Platform. So in my first video, I've already explained the basic concept of cloud storage, and also there is a demo where I have explained you how you can create your bucket, upload your object and do all sort of things. For example, copy the object, delete the object, give it the permission so that it can be publicly accessible. So if you haven't seen that video, it's highly recommended that you see the video. I'll put the link in the description of this video as well as the top right corner. So it's highly recommended that you first watch that video because that is the prerequisite of this particular video. So in this video, what I'm going to cover is that what is the versioning, retention and lifecycle of cloud storage. So let's see that in a demo. So here I am in my Google Cloud console. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a bucket by clicking on create here. And let's give it a name as Technical Potpourri September 19th. Continue. On here, I'll choose multi-region. I'll choose standard. Here, I will choose make it publicly available. But this is important. I want to show you first the object versioning. So here you will configure the versioning of the particular file. So let's understand this concept first. So let's say you have a bucket. Under that bucket, you have a file called Hello World. Now you want to modify that file and create a new version called Hello World version 1. Now when you create version 1, what you will do with your previous version 0? You want to keep that version 0 for some amount of time, so that if needed, you can always restore your version 0. So what we'll do here, we'll configure or we'll tell Google Cloud that how many versions we want to keep for a particular file. Is it one version, two version, three version, or five versions, right? And how long we want to keep that version so that we can always go back and restore that. So that's what this object versioning is all about. So let's configure that. So here in the object version, the first thing is that how many versions per object we are allowed. For example, I want for each particular object, I want 5 versions. And how long you want your versions to stay. So I want after 7 days, if I am not utilizing my version, then Google Cloud is going to go and delete that version. So basically what I'm telling is that if I put 7 days, it means after 7 days, my old versions will be deleted from the Google Cloud platform. So within the 7 days, I have the opportunity to go and restore my old version. So I configure that and click on create. And then it's actually created my bucket. Now let's upload a file. This is my file which is being uploaded. So if I click on that, you can see this is my particular file. And if I go to my version history, I can see this is my version. Now I have this particular file. Let's assume I have already changed the file in my local drive and I want to upload the file again. So when I'll do that, see there is already a particular file. So what is trying to tell me, what you want to do? You want to overwrite the file, or you want to exclude object from this upload. So I'll say overwrite the file and continue upload. So upload is done. Now if I go back to this file and click on version, I can see there's 2 versions. This was my old and this is my new. I can always go back my previous version and click on restore. So how long this version will active? This version will be active for 7 days. After 7 days, this version will be deleted from the Google Cloud platform. So this is the way how you can configure your versioning in Google Cloud storage. Now I'm going to explain you what is the retention. So again, I'll create a bucket. Let's give it a name as Technical Potpourri September 19. All this good. I'll always choose basic. Here, I'll choose the retention policy. So what is the retention policy? Retention policies is basically, I want to configure how long I want my file to be secured. For example, let's say I upload a file And then I don't want somebody to go and modify or delete the file for this number of days or this number of minutes, right? So this is what I'm going to configure in the retention policy. Think this way. You have a use case that every time you create, you upload a transaction file, transaction record, right? You don't want your transaction records to be deleted for 1 year for your audit purpose. How you can do that's called the retention policy. That's where you configure your retention policy. So for this demo, what I want to do, I want to make sure once a file is being uploaded, I don't want that file to be deleted for next 10 minutes. I cannot do minutes, but I can do, let's say you cannot delete that file for next 120 seconds, which is basically 2 minutes, right? And then create. Perfect. So my bucket is ready. Now I'm going to create and I'm going to upload the file. You can see here that it's telling you want to upload a file and then it has an active retention policy of 2 minutes. I'm going to confirm that. And my file is uploaded. This particular file cannot be deleted for next 2 seconds. That's why it's the retention policy. It's telling 9:48:57. Till that, I cannot delete the file. So what about if I go and try to delete the file? What will happen? So I click here and I try to delete the file. It's telling that deleting could not be done. And if I click on view details, it's telling that it cannot be done because there is a retention policy. Now, if I wait for 2 minutes, I'll see this retention policy will be gone and then I'll be able to delete the particular file. So let's come back after 2 minutes. Okay, so now I'm back after 2 minutes. My time is 9:49, but the retention policy is will expire as 9:48. So now if I go and try to delete, it's telling that it's trying to delete the particular file and the deletion is done because the retention policy is already expired. So this is the way how you can create your retention policy for your particular bucket. Now I'm going to explain the lifecycle of storage class. This lifecycle is very important to optimize the cost of your cloud storage. So let's understand a use case that you upload a particular file, but then what is the need of that particular file? You want to access that file for next 30 days. Very frequently, right? After the 30 days, you don't want that file to be accessed that frequently. And then you only want that file for your quarterly report. Then if you create a bucket with a standard storage, then it makes sense you upload a file with standard storage, you'll be frequently accessing the file for 30 days, which is absolutely good. But what about after 30 days? You don't want that file to be frequently used. So basically then you want your file to move to a nearline storage or a cold line storage because you want to use that file only for your quarterly report, right? So how you can handle that? How you can create a rule that after 30 days, all my files should move from standard storage to a cold line storage or a nearline storage? How you can do that? That's what I'm going to show you. And that's what the lifecycle of cloud storage is all about. So let's create a bucket first. Let's give it a name. Let's choose standard, continue, and then let's create. Yeah, let's confirm. Now everything is done. I'm going to upload a particular file. The file is being uploaded. It's in the standard storage. All looks good. Now, if I go to the lifecycle, this is where you create your lifecycle rule. So I'll create a rule that I want to set the storage class to nearline. So what is nearline and what is cold line? So nearline is basically you choose nearline when you want to access your file every 30, once in a 30 days. And cold line is basically once in a quarter. So my requirement is like after 30 days, I don't want my file to be frequently accessible. I want that file to be there and it will only be accessed once in a quarter for a quarterly report. My action is I want to set the storage class to cold line. continue, and then when the age becomes 30 days, when my age of the file becomes 30 days, I want that file to move to my cold line storage, because I don't want that file to be staying in the standard storage, because that incurs cost, right? Moving to the cold line storage is basically reducing my cost. And I can click on create, is basically create the rule. At the same time, what I want it to move to an archive after 365 days. I can create another rule, is that you can move it to set the storage class to archive once the age becomes 365 days. And it creates another rule. So after 30 days, it will move to cold line. After 365 days, it moves to archive. And finally, I can create one more rule, is that delete the object once the age becomes, let's say, 500 days. After 500 days, I don't want that file. This is the way how you can create your multiple lifecycle rules. And it is very important, because this helps you to reduce your cost in Google Cloud Platform. So that's all for today's video. I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share. And please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.